Amen.
Because it is not befitting for you to serve God and to suffer. So anyone that wants us to suffer should suffer because we are serving God. That is it. The Lord has led me to lead you the topic for today. It's called the theme. You remember the theme of this revival says, the blood that speaketh better thing. I'm going to take you to what is called the victorious dimension of the blood today. So another time I'll take you through what is called the protective dimension. And I'll also let you know what is called the prosperous dimension of God's blood. The blood of Jesus is a multi-purpose blood. It does everything, virtually everything. As a matter of fact, everyone in the Bible is a drop of his blood.
Oh my God.
Do you ever think of that? Each verse of the Bible represents a drop of his blood. That you pick the blood of his blood. So if you see the word of God as the drop of his word, of his blood, then you it carries more meaning to you than any other person that just sees it as just an ordinary word. Amen. Amen. Turn your Bible with me to the book of Isaiah chapter 63. I'm going to talk about the topic victorious blood. Like I said, for this program will not be exceeding 9 p.m. I'm still going to stand on that principle. I believe in timekeeping. Amen. Amen. So, the sermon will be very brief, straight to the point, and is going to empower you. By the time you'll be leaving here, you'll leave this place with potentials in the name of Jesus. I'm going to read Isaiah chapter 63. The meaning of the word Isaiah means God saves. Or God is Savior. I'm not going to go into details about Isaiah now. He's one of the major prophets. And he was called by God at a time when the sin of the Israelites was really enormous. Isaiah 63 from Israel. Who is this coming from the city of Bozrah in Edom? Bozrah is a city that is in Edom. Who is this so splendidly dressed in red, marching along in power and strength? It is the Lord, powerful to see, an answer to that. Coming to announce his victory. By the time you leave this place today, you are going to make something. It is called a victorious announcement.
Amen.
When somebody is looking for a job and it tells the wife, sweetheart, I'm going out, I pray today will be good. By the time it comes back home and it tells the wife, I have a victorious announcement. Do you know I got the job? That is called a victorious announcement. There are two types of announcement, either someone making a defeating announcement that has been defeated again today, or another person come to say, I am victorious. I don't know what you are wanting to say. There are some good news that should, some good things that should happen in your life that should make you speak boldly and say, yes, God has done it. When ladies, when they are looking for the right partner, you won't know that ladies too, they really need somebody because they do too much boasting to us. But when someone eventually proposes to them, you say, when you're still talking to them, I'm not ready. And when you tell them and they are happy about it, you don't go to work and say, oh, no, 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 no. You won't believe it, somebody just is giving me a ring. Victorious announcement. I think it's victorious announcement. I have a child now. Victorious announcement. I prophesy into your life that unfruitfulness shall turn to fruitfulness.
Amen.
I prophesy into your life.
Amen.
your life shall be productive.
Amen.
I prophesy into your life. In this month of April, you will make a victorious
announcement.
The problem that people have attached to your name, that they've known you by, the Bible recorded that they write a woman's name and they say the name of the woman is called the woman with the issue of blood. The book of Luke chapter 8 verse 43 to 45. We know they who called him Bartimaeus, at least he said Bartimaeus the blind man. But we can see his name in front of it, Bartimaeus. We also know of Lazarus, even though he died, he gave him a name. But I read my Bible clearly and I could not find the name of the woman with the issue of blood. She had a stigma for 12 good years, a daily flow of blood, and as a result of that, people forget to mention her name because they see the name as something irrelevant. Where people have seen you as an irrelevant person,
amen,
God will make you relevant. See, there are some things that will happen in your life that will make you relevant. When Joseph heard the interpretation of the dream, he said, "You need to find somebody that can manage." Pharaoh said, who is that person that is wise like you that can do it? You are the relevant person. Indeed, he's a relevant person, but he was under your custody in the prison. When God made you relevant, your position will change.
Amen.
Because God made him relevant, his position changed from a prisoner to a prime minister. I'm talking about the victorious blood. The victorious blood carries a locomotive power that takes people from where they are to where they are supposed to be, regardless of age or timing of life. Because Revelation 1 verse 6 says, "I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, the Lord God Almighty." So in other words, God tells you when is the beginning and when the end is, not you to tell him when the end or the beginning is. And now the woman, for me to tell you about what is called victorious blood, I must also tell you something called the defeating blood. And this is where the knowledge is. Please listen attentively. There are three forms of blood that will bring about the fall of man. The defeating blood, three forms of blood that will bring about the fall of man. Genesis 49, verse 1 to 3. What is called the blood of your parent? That is one of the blood that can defeat a man. The second blood that can defeat a man is called your own blood. When you enter a covenant with your own blood, a lady in love entered a covenant with a brother in Nigeria. The brother traveled to America without telling her. As a result of that, I heard that the lady is now mentally retarded. She's having mental problem. They said they took her to many churches in Nigeria, but yet she's not healed. I don't know if you heard of the story. I recently heard the story last week. Yeah, God bless you. As they speak, they say she's still currently mad. And the third form of blood that can defeat people is called the blood of the innocent. I start again. The blood of the poet, your own blood, and the blood of the innocent. About your own blood could be in different dimension. It could be the blood of the children they want to use to attack you. It could be your own blood as a technically your blood. It could be people that are also your relative, more or less siblings. Indeed, they are your blood. The Spirit of God is telling you, don't watch this thing for them. But I would give you an exposition of what the defeating blood is today. Then probably tomorrow I'll tell you about the victorious blood. Because if you don't know how you are fallen, you might not know how. See, one thing about people in this life is that people are always in their own lives, but they don't take on what makes them fall. See, when you fall down and you are in a hurry to rise up, you should always think of what made you fall. Because if you cannot give an answer to what made you fall, if you rise up again, there is tendency you might still fall. That is why the Bible says, if a young person falls down, they will look forward. But if someone that is an elderly person falls down, they will look backward to see what is the cause of their falling. Even if it was a rope that is laid on the floor that has missed somebody fall, perhaps there's another two layers in front. If you see that it's a rope, you look down and saw it, then you know how to escape your way from all that traps so that you won't fall. Jesus was saying to the disciples at some point when I was reading the scripture, said, I have come to turn the father against this son, brother-in-law against daughter-in-law. I have seen what Satan is using nowadays, and I see that Satan is using families against themselves. Daughters against their mother, mothers against their daughters. And it's using the internal people to penetrate. I was conducting an event for a pastor's wife. Technically, they made her mad for roughly 8 years in the United Kingdom. She was mad for 8 years. Then the pastor told me about it. I said, you know what? God can heal her. As I speak, she's currently healed. I said, it's not even going to take up to 5 minutes. And the pastor was like, but you go to mountain of this and that. I said, don't worry. Don't tell me how many more things you've been to. I said, one thing I will do is that I will first find out the source of the problem. And when God tells me the source of the problem, then I will know what to do. Ask me what the source of the problem was. Anyone went to attack the pastor, and they asked themselves in the witchcraft kingdom that how can they attack him? And they said, one of them had a suggestion that they would go that, and the one that said she had a suggestion happened to be the mother-in-law of the pastor. And she said, I have the key to their house. And they asked her, what is the key to their house? She said, our own biological daughter is the wife of that pastor. That if she can attack her own biological daughter, then the pastor will not be able to concentrate. Then they can then attack the pastor. And that is how they did it. The pastor prayed to say that he felt, does he still know how to pray? But on the day God was to rescue the sister, it was just one Bible verse. I remember God gave me Isaiah 52 verse 2. I said, look here, the Lord told me your wife will deliver than one verse. He said, shake yourself from the dust, all you captive daughter of Zion. And that is all I said. As I said it to her 3 times, shake yourself from the dust. The 3rd time she fell down, stood up, and she became normal. And I told the man of God, I said, this is your wife. And he looked at my face and said, Pastor, let me see you privately. Then he went to another place and said, I want her to still go back to the place. Are you really sure that there will be no problem? I looked at his face. I said, do you have faith? He said, I speak to you now. Affliction will arise the 2nd time. Don't let her go back to where they're looking after them. Let them reassess your wife. Call as a, you have a right to call for what? Reassessment. If she passes the reassessment, then you know she's healed. They did a reassessment, and after the reassessment, they said numerically, grammatically, everything is fine. And since last 2 years that God has done it, as I speak, she's still normal. What brought about a falling? The defeating blood. You are where you are. are today because you are defeated by some bloods. Many have been defeated by the blood of their husband that disappointed them. Many have been defeated by the blood of someone their grandfather or their parent have done evil to that are innocent people. The Bible says the blood of Abel is asking for vengeance. I know a particular family, all they are praying for is the fruit of the womb. And after praying with them, I discovered that their uncle persuaded somebody to do an abortion. And as a result of the abortion, the lady died. So the mother of this girl now said, our holy daughter has been killed innocently. And she said it to their family. If I mention the name of the family, so people here will know the family I'm talking about. Because that woman became a very frequent problem in the family, that if you want to marry from that family, they say, do you know there's this problem there? It became a name tag. And the woman said, from the family which this has happened, that as many of their girls that are there, they will find it hard to see the fruit of the womb. It did not just go like that, it went as in it became a compound cause in that family. As I speak, the way I met two sisters that happened to be of the same family, I said, this is where the problem comes from. And the solution is this. We prayed, and to the glory of God, they are now, two of them that I know are carrying a baby. During the period of this problem, they normally tell them to go to their own country. They say they have to go and make rituals to one god of water, marine water. They made rituals to marine water. Roughly every year they travel to marine water spirit. The marine spirit didn't do anything about it. Why are you going to the god that cannot save? When the blood that is called the victorious blood has given you the victory. I'm going to conclude today on this note. Many Christians are looking for victory where there is no victory. There is no other name through which you can be saved except the name of Jesus. And the Bible says in Philippians 2 verse 10 that the mention of the name of Jesus, every name shall bow. And every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Proverbs 16 verse 1 says, the preparation of the heart belongs to man, but the answers to what is spoken in the tongue belongs to God. Many people might have cursed you, but if they curse you and God blesses you, then curses is not yours. Genesis 12 verse 3 says, Abraham, whosoever blesses you shall be blessed, and whosoever curses you shall be cursed. I'm going to stop here because I said we won't take much time. As you are sitting down, you are going to say, every evil blood, every blood,
every blood
that has brought condemnation upon my life,
Jesus Christ
of Nazareth, justify me from them to me. Open your mouth and pray, Father, in the name of Jesus. Every blood that has brought condemnation upon my life, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, justify me from them to me. Because the word of God knows that sometimes Satan may want to use your mother or your father to attack you. Then God made provision in the scripture so that when your father or your mother is one that is binding you with blood, you can set yourself free through the word. Psalm 27 verse 10 says, my father and my mother will abandon me, but the Lord will take care of me. You are going to say, the blood of Jesus,
the blood of Jesus,
in the areas,
in the areas
where my parents have let me down, fine-tune my destiny. Open up and pray, Father, in the name of Jesus. The blood of Jesus, in the areas Although my parents have left me now. Although my siblings have left me now. Where my elder ones have left me now. The blood of Jesus finds me against me. Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name of God. You're going to pray for yourself. You say blood covenant. When you talk of blood covenant, you make a lot of blood covenant without even knowing you've made a blood covenant. Amen. Some of you, you just kiss and say, accidentally, as you are kissing. The person's blood, you bite the person accidentally, the blood touches your tongue. That is covenant. Anything that brings about an exchange of blood into your system, the exchange of blood into your system and his blood into your system is a covenant. For your information, similarly, sexual intercourse is a covenant and it's called a blood covenant. It's called a blood covenant. I'm going to end on this note. My younger brother, not someone else, made a blood covenant with somebody. Just by sleeping with the person, not knowing who the person is. I wondered what I said. I said, listen, this person is not your set. He said, oh, you can see the lady is fine, beautiful, set. I kept my mouth shut and I began to pray because I knew that he was in trouble. One day the sister, just a 19-year-old girl, in the physical realm, in the spiritual realm, you hear her age. She came to my house and at 12 p.m. I said, Pastor, I woke up but I did not know what pushed me to your house, what brought me to your house. I knew it was the power that I could not stand. And she said, our companion tried to stop her from making the confession, but the power of God forced her to my house. My wife was there and I said, should my wife excuse you? She said, no, let her sit down. And they said, I want your younger brother to be here. Then I said, okay, I'll call for him. Come. She started the confession. She said, look at me. She said, Pastor, I am 289 years. That is point one. She said, this is the fifth time she's coming to this planet. She said, look at me very well. Your younger brother thought he can just mess around with me. And what he did was that he slept with your friend and he was even waiting to tell you that I slept with your friend. She said, you know what? I will finish him up. But I can't do it anymore. I said, why? She said, because I'm supposed to finish my 3 days vigil today, but your God had an encounter with me. And that is why I am here to submit. I said, what is your prayer if you are making any VG? She said, our prayer is that God should not have mercy on my younger brother. She said, but your own prayers taught a prayer, and that is why she's here for confession. Then I looked. Why she was confessing my younger brother and was frustrated? I said, if you look up, whatever you see, you get frustrated like that on the floor. Now, and I said, what are you holding my brother with? She said, the power I'm using over your brother is that we have made a blood covenant. Then I look into her face and said, for it is written in Colossians 2, verse 14 and 15. That every ordinance is a covenant that is victory against him has been blotted by the blood of Jesus. Christ has emerged upon the cross, triumphing over his bands and powers, and has made them a public ridicule. She said, I have another thing to tell you. She said, she's put his glory on a chair that his hand can never touch in life. Because that chair is very high and is in heaven. That's all very good. But also, Ecclesiastes 5, verse 8 also says, now when the wicked does their evil, he that is higher than the highest seeth them and he knows how to pay them back. Said, if God is higher than the highest, wherever you call your highest place, can the hand of God touch that place? She said, the hand of the King of Glory can touch it. I don't even know if she knows how to praise God very well. But I said, the hand of God can touch it. As I speak right now, I release it from there, back to Him. She said, but you are not fair now. He's done evil, but you are not fair on me. You just set me free of everything. But we are going to have the punishment for him. I said, did I bring you here? She said, no. I said, you just, let's carry on. The next one, continue. The next thing she said was, but if you do everything, there is a mark they put on his head. That mark, nobody can remove it. Then this is the conclusion. I said, but what about the blood of Jesus? Can it wash it away? And she prostrated before me and said, the blood of Jesus, they cannot withstand it. Anything that blood does is final. Stand up in God's presence. I am talking from practical example. The person I'm speaking of, Prophet Allah will know the person. If you see her in the physical realm, she is very, very beautiful. If you are a brother and you are not feeling in spirit, you will think God has shown you the right one. If you only assess ladies by front and back, she would have thrown you on the back here before you went in trouble. Brothers in the house, if you are to look out for sisters, pray and be sure you are not marrying a Jezebel. All some brothers look for is anything that is light in complexion or anything that it is set in front and set at the back. Just looking for figurines, Coca-Cola's bottle. May God help your eyes to see the right things.
Amen.
So that your eyes don't, your hand don't pick the wrong thing.
Amen.
That will make things wrong in your life.
Amen.
You see sisters that are cool in Christ. Then just sister that has godly, you say this one, no action. You look for action until you see James Bond. I want you to pray and say, every satanic mark upon my destiny.
Every satanic mark upon my destiny.
By the reason of the blood of Jesus.
By the reason of the blood of Jesus.
It's the last prayer point, and that's why I'm stopping for today because of time. I am doing out of victory. Open your mouth and go. Every satanic mark upon my destiny. By the reason of the blood of Jesus, I am doing out of victory. And I said, you will fight for somebody here, that when he's fighting for you, the enemy that you are begging, that says they will not have pity on you, they will beg you, and you will not even know what to say. Maybe there's some stubborn enemy, they will beg you, have experienced something similar. Just, it may not because they are so powerful, but we just respect them as every person. This person in my own case, I said, what is the problem now? If there's anything we've done wrong, sorry. She said, I'll make it for you. I will fight. And I was like, it is not that you have a spiritual power that is stronger than the power of my God. I'm just using courtesy. But when it came to God, I said, this person, God, is my courtesy is not working for this person. I said, God, the God of my calling. Arise and show me or her. Arise and show her that you have called me. When God started with her, I pity her. As I am, I'm still pitying her. Because I went to God and said, God, how is she going to get out of this place? God said, it's none of your business now, it's my business. And God said, and when I'm through with her, I'll let you know. Now, when the world, how do you sort that out? When your enemy, when God arise to fight your enemy, when it's fighting them, you would have no faith because he will tell you when it's true, you will let him know. And when God says when it's true, at the point he tells me now, I'm saying, God, hey, this one, I can't stand it. And God says, I have done with them. Let us pray. Speak of the living God will bless you for a time like this. Thank you for his position to where this called the victorious blood. I pray, God, be the last that will make your blood to rescue us. let it rest me of God. Let every systemic mass and ignorances also be removed by the wisdom of the Lord. Give us victory.
Amen.
That the name of the Lord be glorified.
Amen.
In Jesus' name, the Lord pray.
Amen.
Let's give it to Jesus. Give it to Jesus. God bless you. Sit down in God's presence. Of the time, I'm going to invite the choir quickly. Let's just